So talk about how much of the show, so that piece of paper that you wrote those initial notes on, how much of it by the end of it was actually done? Did you do what you wanted to do?
At the end of the day, we got about 80, 85% of what I wanted to do with that story. We had to compensate for losing some cast members, physical production things that came up. But yeah, we got to do most of it because once we got to pick up the series, which almost didn't happen because of Star Trek, after our episode two of year two, we got no notes from Warner Brothers. They left us alone. It was benign neglect. They didn't promote us. They didn't help us. They didn't get in our way. So I got to write whatever I wanted to write. And that kind of creative freedom doesn't happen very often. So I got pretty much everything I wanted. But we almost didn't get there because after we shot the pilot, I got a call from Walter Koenig, who played Chekhov on Star Trek, who was having lunch with a guy at Paramount. He said, I want you to know they're doing a show based on a space station, diplomatic outpost, jump gate nearby, commander with a sort of a mystical history and destiny, and female second in command, and a changeling, which you have in your movie. And they're trying to subvert what you're doing and co-opt it. Because at that time, Warner's and Paramount were doing two different competing networks. And they figured, well, we can take what they're doing in Babylon 5 and co-opt it. We can sell it and take and kill their show. So they were actually telling stations, if you buy Babylon 5, you can have Deep Space Nine. They tried to sink us wherever they possibly could. They're going to look like crap. They told people that our Babylon 5 is going to look cheap and terrible. They did everything they possibly could to stop us. It was trench warfare for a long time, and they almost sank our ship. But I think more pissed off than anything else, Warner decided to go ahead with it. But it was a pretty obvious riff on our show because, in fact, one of the cast members found Peter Jurisic, who played Londo on our show at a party, pulled him aside, said, "I want you to know, all of us on DS9 know that our show came from your show, and on behalf of the cast, good luck." Which said a lot.
And you never wanted to take it into any kind of legal battle
I
or
did.
anything
I
like
wanted to sue their asses off, but Warner said, "Look, if we sue them, they'll countersue us. Both shows could be lost in litigation, and you'll never get your opportunity." So I bit the bullet and didn't take action because Warner's owned the show at that point. So we had to sort of sit back and watch them try and eat our lunch every week.
that? It was interesting because Majel Barrett Roddenberry actually appeared on an episode of Babylon 5. Was that intentional regarding what had happened?
Yeah, well, I know she wasn't happy with what they were doing either. And we reached out to Majel and said, we'd love to have you come on the show sometime as a show of support of the Star Trek universe and the creators for what we're doing, as opposed to what they're doing over there. And she was happy to be part of that conversation. So, yeah, she made an appearance on our show.